Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to Porto. I will have to address a few words first in Portuguese, and then I'll pass on to English, because there are some issues which are of political relevance which I want to announce, and I have to do it in Portuguese for obvious reasons. Senhora Alta Comissária das Nações Unidas para os Direitos Humanos, Michelle Bachelet, Senhor Presidente Dr. Jorge Sampaio, Senhores representantes dos governos dos países de língua oficial portuguesa, senhores deputados, senhora diretora executiva da Harm Reduction International, senhor diretor executivo da Agência Piaget para o Desenvolvimento, senhoras e senhores conferencistas, minhas senhoras e meus senhores. O que temos nós feito? A reorganização da rede social do município, que visa uma intervenção concertada entre 200 instituições públicas e privadas, tendo em vista uma cidade mais coesa. A coordenação do NEPISA, Núcleo de Planeamento e Intervenção de Pessoas Sem Abrigo, a quem compete fazer o diagnóstico, planeamento e ativar as redes de resposta, potenciando o trabalho em rede e gerando complementaridade das mais de 60 instituições e entidades parceiras. A adesão do Porto à Rede Portuguesa de Municípios Saudáveis, que integra a rede da Organização Mundial de Saúde, a elaboração do Plano Municipal de Saúde, que visa o desenvolvimento de políticas e medidas de promoção de saúde, a elaboração de um relatório sobre o uso de substâncias psicoativas na cidade pelo Instituto de Saúde Pública da Universidade do Porto, que apresenta um retrato do uso de tabaco, álcool e substâncias ilícitas na cidade, evidencia o trabalho que é necessário continuar a fazer nesse âmbito. A subscrição dos compromissos da iniciativa Fast Track Cities, Cidades na Via Rápida para acabar com a epidemia VIH. O Porto elaborou e aprovou recentemente o primeiro plano estratégico integrado pelo consórcio constituído por cerca de 30 instituições com atuação no território concelhio, que será publicamente apresentado no próximo dia 20 de maio. No que respeita à relação da proximidade dos cidadãos e às instituições ao património humano e ao cariz empreendedor que nos caracteriza, entendemos que podemos e devemos desempenhar um papel fundamental nas políticas de promoção da saúde, auxiliando na operacionalização a nível local do Plano Nacional de Saúde e dos programas prioritários que dele resultam, bem como fazer uso do nosso capital de iniciativa, replicar modelos e iniciativas que muito beneficiarão a nossa comunidade. Compete-me também, por isso, e neste dia muito importante para a cidade do Porto, e depois dos contactos já havidos também com a Senhora Secretária de Estado, apesar de ser um assunto que tem vindo a ser discutido eternamente na Assembleia Municipal do Porto, eu queria anunciar que o Município do Porto irá apoiar a criação de uma unidade móvel de consumo assistido como mais uma resposta de saúde pública. Queria dizer também que esta não deve ser uma operação municipal, deve ser um apoio da Câmara Municipal, política e também estratégica da Câmara Municipal do Porto, àquilo que o Ministério da Saúde e as nossas excelentes organizações não-governamentais serão certamente capazes de providenciar a todos aqueles que precisam. Portanto, queria deixar esta nota. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I just announced that after some time in which we have discussed assisted consumption, we will be supporting the, together with the Ministry of Health and the ONGs in the city, a mobile unit that will assist consumption. This is a major event for us. Believe me, it's not a very easy decision. I'm not more popular than I was 5 minutes ago, but that's okay. It's part of my job. Another thing I would like to let you know is how proud we are in Portugal. That this is no matter a matter of the Ministry of Justice. 20 years ago, it changed, and now it has to do with the Minister of Health. This is a major change, and for all of you who live in countries who have not yet changed that, please do. It's vital. It is fundamental. It has to do with us. The thing that struck me some years ago, maybe 25 or 30 years ago when I came to live in Portugal, was we had a problem with alcohol consumption, we still have, but this was not criminalized, whereas everything which had to do with drugs was criminalized. And President George Sampaio was certainly the person who inspired us to change this. We are very proud, and this is something we have to continue. We have to work on that. A little bit about the city of Porto. You probably had a look around. It's a small city. It is a city which is, we try to make it comfortable and interesting for everyone, where since 5 years ago we have decided, as an independent movement, we wanted to change the issues on the city, and we identified three main factors for the city, which was culture, social cohesion, and employment. This was a time when we had 17% unemployment, now we have under 7%, fortunately, when a lot of young people were unemployed, and we thought culture is the melting cement for a city. So, believe me, and this is in my heart, culture is probably the most important fact in any human development in this century. It is what might change the world, because it's through culture that you develop, for instance, the capacity we have to change this planet into a sustainable planet. Culture is also what contributes for older and younger to meet together, richer and poorer to meet together, for people who have different ideologies to meet together. It's through culture. And culture is also very important in terms of the issues we are discussing here. Why? Because after 20 years, what are the good news and the bad news? For my generation, of course, I saw many of my friends dying from drug abuse back in the 70s. A lot of them. Because suddenly democracy happened in Portugal. A lot of my friends died, school friends. They died from heroin, basically. Lots of them. Maybe 25% of my colleagues in high school died. It was terrible. And now we have achieved this. We have achieved a time when it is looked by the health system, where we are all more tolerant. And also the patterns of consumption changed. However, we have now a new generation of kids. Generation of kids who are the age of my younger son. And now they look at it differently somehow. But looking at it differently means at the same time you still have to tell them what is dangerous and what is not dangerous. It is a matter of culture again. It is a matter, we seem to be able to tell them that it's wrong to smoke cigarettes. We are unable to tell them that it's very wrong when they are 15 or 16 years old to buy bottles of beer and drink bottles of beer until they are sick and they end up in hospital. And we seem unable to tell them that some of the new drugs are as dangerous, or mostly more dangerous than the older ones. So we just have to go hand in hand. At the same time, to look after those who need, to be tolerant, to be open, but not to forget that this is a curse we have lived with. We live with many curses. That's part of our lives. But we should not forget that ultimately we have to do something in schools. And it is with the young kids that it might make a change. Thank you very much. Good work.